Well, it's nearing 7 o'clock, which means it's time for our weekly Wednesday catch-up with National Party leader Judith Collins. Morning, Ms. Collins.
Oh, good morning, Chris. Lovely to see you.
Lovely to see you too. You must be thrilled that Jacinda Ardern is, like you hoped for, going to be coming to Auckland next week.
Yes, I think it's a good idea, and the fact that Trevor Mallard has just strangely changed the rulings obviously works out well for her, but she needs to get to Auckland, hasn't been here for 3 months. She needs to actually not get past the people that she normally Zooms with and go out and see some of the small business people.
Come on, I think that's a little bit cynical, isn't it? I mean, do we really need her here? She's got
cabinet ministers. She's the one who said she didn't need to come here.
She's got ministers here on the ground for her. Does she really need to be here? I don't know if Aucklanders really feel that they need to see her, do they?
Well, if she's not welcome, is what you're saying. I think Aucklanders will welcome her. She is, after all, the MP for Mount Albert. I think she will. Aucklanders will be pleased to see her come here because it's been 3 months. I actually was really shocked yesterday to hear from a Wellingtonian, which I never thought I'd hear, that nobody in Wellington cares about Auckland. And I thought, what a cynical thing to say. Let's make sure that Jacinda Ardern has a good time in Auckland.
Of course they care about it. Well, I'm a Wellingtonian. I've grown to love Auckland, so I think we'll be able to move past that. Look, the far north has been locked down for a week. Given the low vaccination rates, do you think that's a good move from Minister Hipkins?
Well, of course, again, they don't share the public health advice other than what they've released during the press conferences. So obviously they've done it because they feel they need to. We've got very low vaccination rates in the far north. That's why Dr. Shane Retty's been up there now for weeks doing vaccinations. He's doing more this week. That's basically, we believe that that is an area that needs to be targeted.
I saw Shane Retty on Q&A about a week ago. He was really concerned, given the uptake of vaccination rates, not just for COVID-19, but for all immunisations. How important is it, do you think, that we've got those boots on the ground doing that work for that particular region?
Well, I think it's crucial, and the fact, particularly for the Māori health providers to be empowered, and they should have been far earlier on, it is really important that we get the vaccination, not only for COVID, but as you rightly say, for the, you know, all the other vaccinations that we need for children in particular, get them out to those vulnerable communities where particularly they are, it's a long way to go to the doctor, if you're even registered with a doctor, and it is sometimes important. You have to just go to people rather than the other way around.
One of those groups that are trying to go to people are the gangs. Willie Jackson has been working with them to bring out this campaign. We're going to hear from him just after 7 o'clock this morning. But what do you make of that? Do you think that's a good thing, reaching those hard-to-get people, those marginalised members of society, and working with them to try to get more people vaccinated?
Look, they're the people who sell methamphetamine, so don't try and make them look like they're victims. They're actually not necessarily good people at all. But even then, if they get COVID-19, they're also at risk of spreading it to other people, including their children. And it is important to get everyone vaccinated, but let's not bring out the song sheet for them.
No. I don't think we're doing that. But I think we all know that. Yes, gangs aren't people's cup of tea, and that's putting it mildly, but it's important we get to those regions because we can't just say, look, you choose not to be a part of normal society, you're on your own, but it's not just a case of that. People need to be vaccinated because the virus can mutate in those situations and it's better for our safety. So surely it's a good thing that Mr. Jackson is getting side by side with them to promote for this.
Well, he's done very little in the last 3 months of the Auckland lockdown that we can see. So we just think, just get everyone vaccinated, because what we know is that the gang members can spread it to other people as well. They spread it within their own families. It is really important that we get people vaccinated. And I'd say just get everyone vaccinated. And you do what you have to do to do it, but let's not think that this has been a great rollout, which is why I really do need a Royal Commission into what's happened with Delta and the unpreparedness, the refusal to use the Māori health providers earlier in the year. All of these things needs to be looked at.
I know you've got some thoughts on the messaging around the vaccine rollout, the spin, if shall we say, for how it's been handled. What do you feel in terms of the government control of the message and letting us know when vaccines are available and procuring them and that sort of thing?
Yes, well, some very good work from media has uncovered that last year the government spent actually 3 months talking about the messaging and paying for the messaging and what they were going to talk about with vaccines, rather than actually just getting the vaccines ordered. And it is really important that when you are actually trying to negotiate to get vaccines in a timely manner, that you put the money into getting people to do that. And instead, they spent 3 months on the messaging that they would give, rather than actually on getting the negotiation started.
Ms. Collins, I'm sure you're looking forward to joining up with your old sparring partners again soon, John and Indira. But thanks very much for joining us this morning at 7 o'clock. So we'll get
to
the
news.
Thank you,
Chris.